good. This is your boy LaSalle, aka Girly, aka Mr. Handsome, and this is gonna be my first review on a wedding. I am going to review a couple of things that I do and a couple of events that I see. I might pull some video off Facebook and do my review on it as well. Okay, my first review. This wedding was coordinated by some good persons that do decor. As you can see, how much the decor look good and radiant. It was one of the biggest wedding that I've attended in a long time. I mean, so much people was at this wedding. The bride and the groom was fabulous. However, I fell asleep in the church because of I was so tired, so I fell asleep in the church.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening. I think that I are alive. Yes, I are alive, and I just want to tell you how privileged I am to be at this lovely wedding. And it is more and more exciting for me, because within the family, this is my third wedding with them. And the reason why I said my third wedding, they booked me until I die. We just can't wait until they call if it's somebody else, man. Hurry up. And the proposed, because I'm me, yes ma'am, I'm me, the MC. You know, we're going to bless the food and we're going to talk. And I've seen a lot of Caucasian. Hi, how are you doing? I'm very upset with you this evening. We're talking, and I want somebody to translate. I'm very upset with you guys. You know, I went to my friend's wedding and I was here. You know, and I do a couple of shows before, I was tired. This lady, I was tired. But I come anyway, and I sit in the back of the church. When they walk in, I was there. When they do the vow, I was there. You see, so when they went to sign the paper, I decided to go into the back of the church, up the upstairs. And I lay down, and I fell asleep right here. When the song was playing, and I see the Caucasian get up, and everybody was dancing, I said, oh my God, where am I? I thought I was at Reggae Sun Splash on Steam. I never seen so much, and then guess what? The church, the wedding over, and not one of you wait the person is a handsome list, so you did not wait here. And that's why I vexed you tonight. But for me, when I wake up from Sweden, when I wake up, everybody come out to church. I'm a celebrity again because I think I was still around. And here I am dreaming about the wedding. Give the bride and the groom a round of applause. Yeah. You know, they didn't tell me the dress code. They did not. But me thank God me come in and me go and catch it. At least one color on the table matching, even if I don't like something like this, and matching it. Give myself a round of applause for that. Love you. I see, you see. What we don't understand that in Jamaica they have cash for gold, and this one coming with me. I'll take the ticket. Give her a round of applause. Give them a round of applause. It is a beautiful thing. And now I'm going to call my co-host to come and introduce the person who is going to bless the food. And then we're going to bless the food and bless everything one time. Just what we don't want to do two times.
Okay, I'm on many heads. I'm a very talented young lady, as you can recognize. I can do anything you ask me for. I can't sing. But I can organize and I can make people smile. But I can also be very serious when I need to be. And unfortunately, the people across the state of Grace isn't here. So, is anybody that would like to visit family today? Is anybody that would volunteer themselves to stay with Grace on behalf of the Right, Andrew? Anyone? Nobody wants to say the grace and bless the food? Three. Oh no, thank you. This is what real love is. You want to pray? Okay then. But that's love, because normally everybody looks away from me, because I'm going to myself, so I'll tell you, but thank you. So,
thank you. Good night, everyone. You are looking so beautiful tonight. Give yourself a round of applause for being here. So nice. Well, it's a pleasure to be here and take part at this beautiful wedding tonight. You know me. And thank Wendy for bringing me. You're such a darling. You're my sister for life. All right, everyone who love God, just breathe and just look at prayer. Eternal God and our Father, as we come before you tonight, we ask you to bless each and every one of us, and the wife and the husband especially, that they may have a very long-lasting relationship. Some relationship broke up so quick, I wish they have a very prosperous one forever. I pray that each and every one of us in here tonight will always remember there is a God that always makes all things possible. I want you to bless the DJs, bless the video personnel, the chefs, bless all who take part tonight. Bless me, Mr. Michael. Yeah. And bless the food and the drinks while we eat. And bless all the people that have strength that they can have a good night tonight. And we give all the praise to the Lord while everybody say, thank you, Lord. And thank you, Lord, for everything you have done tonight. And I hope that we have a wonderful night. And my host, the Lord bless you. And thank you all for coming. The Lord bless you all. Thank you.
They said, yo, sir, nobody expect that out of you. You see, you can't judge him by the provider. What about I speak intelligent like he just fly down? Yeah, I like that, man. I don't care where you come from, you just arrive. You know, one of applause for that. All right, so, let me just explain something to you. You're not doing long prayer. Wait a minute. Food need to serve. Quickly prayer. Father, thank you for the food. Bless those who cook it. Amen. Does it not? You know. Now, man, they are complaining. I will know they are complaining. Sir, do you know that they told me the weather is 1 o'clock? Even for 1:30, never start 1:30. You see, me and my problem is, can we work it overtime? Sir, I knew without a shadow of a doubt that you was fretting in the church around it. We say the amount of time you see the best man wipe your face, you're sweating you, and one day she's still at home. Now it happened, you never hear a man walk out of a wedding. You're ugly, but woman will love skip wedding. And you know, I want to know, you give your best man holy power. Every minute. Are we best man there? And I'm going to say, why are you going to have two best man? Boy, I know right now with Bob Marley was here, and I'm very proud of you. He's very nice for eternity, man. Clap him, man. One love! What an honor. Let's get Mr. Music Man. Mr. Music Man, do you find a track that you're going to do for me? Suddenly. Give me the other one. Come. One of the reasons why I'm switching now to the saxophone is because we're going to pay the people in the ready place, man. We're going to pay the music department already. We're going to need to get some refund. The place that have no Wi-Fi. I mean, need Wi-Fi to play the song they want to sing. For you, we get the meaning to sing them. As a matter of fact, we are going to demonstrate. What do you know? I mean, as born here, tell us that when you look like a royalty wedding, God knows. I have never gone to a wedding with so much talk here that I feel like we're in a hurry. Because we feel like we fly out. But we can tell you, see the girl who booked me for your wedding, the family who booked me. The first wedding I come, they bring a blessing to me. Do you know that 2 months after the wedding, I went to England? Sure. Yes, 2 months after the wedding, I went to England. But guess what now? I'm here performing again. And by February, I'm going to England again. Come on, let me tell you, man. We are not in here, but sure. And let me tell you. You see the next wedding you're looking for? That wouldn't have one free. We don't charge you. But don't forget now, we're not here if it's late time we want to take today. Are you hungry with me? Yeah. But the reason why we don't charge them, see, let me tell you something. Gratitude is always a must. When I went to England, and they said, Mr. Handsome, where you are? I said, I'm in London. Then they off the up the hospital properly. I'm in London. Which one will be there again? Huh? They was at Wolverhampton. I remember, Mr. Handsome, you're too far. They said, you're so many bus already three and around. Me no be fun, but if you carry go Uber. Me 5 years is 10. I want to 5 years, this lovely family. They take me out shopping. Yeah, man, you treat me good. So the fact that you treat me good, over and I come back the next 2 months from now, we'll do the same thing. Thank you very much. And one of the sisters gives me a brand new S, you know, the ISP on them. She take out the trip right as I give it to me. I tell you, a good family, a good family. Sir, Mr. Waiter, man, touch him. The man and his wife, the officer, and whisper to the woman, brother. I'm going to respect for them, man. No, if you talk to them, come on, and take the mic and talk with everybody here, brother. You need to give my ear. Are you looking, brother? I will pop on the bed and beat your backside up there. Come on, brother.
Well,
now
you're not singing.
Then come, of course, man.
Are
you playing?
So like you got England, you can't carry me too.
You come. You know. They lock my up. Some people are going to do my first song. And this song goes to the bride and the groom. Give them a round of applause. But I tell any lady me I get married to, make sure we don't have a citizenship. I am suffering.
need to marry a woman from Midwest, you don't have nothing to offer me more than R.T. Hamster. I need to fly out! Yes, so I am applauding you. You know what I'm doing? I don't want you to follow me, take what I say. So that it has something what make no sense and everybody follow you. Like for instance, I notice when pastor preach, and pastor always come up with some good sermon. You know the reason why some of you is not successful? Because you're walking around with fear. The reason why you can't get the job, the reason why you can't get the promotion, you're walking around with fear. And I listen to the message and I say, you know, I'm going to apply the message. You know what I did? I went home and I take a bus on my way home. And when the doctor said, fear peace, I said, my pastor told me not to walk with fear. It's enough, it's being nuggets. So I know everything that someone tell you, you know. So we are waiting on the waiter to come and get my program. Where's my phone? Where is Dawn? Where is Dawn? I don't get my program and I need my program. And we're gonna have a lot of toast. We're gonna have a lot of toast. And now we're gonna hear Louis Fall, the saxophone.
I will say that.
of applause. A round of applause. We are going to run into some stuff. I would like to call on the waiter to bring out the wine.
The next thing I realize is when it's time for the food to serve, I realized that there was only two waiter. You have about two people serving and two waiter. With that much persons, I know they should have bring more people. When I asked one of the waiter what happened to the rest of the service, the server, he said, we short staff. Then I said to him, then you didn't know that there was going to be so much person at the wedding? Of course they know, because when you book a catering service, they say how much people you expect. You're going to give them the amount of people they expect, because everybody's supposed to get food. The thing that I was mostly upset about, when he said, he come to me and said, sir, I would like for you to call table by table. I said, okay, wish I know something that I always do, you know, table one, table two, and go down the line. My thing was to call the first table, but when he said to me, I must make the bridal party come, I was like, excuse me? I said, sir, I thought you guys was going to serve the bridal party. You serve the bride and the groom, but the bridal party have to join the line. I said, yo, man. I mean, people, I really get upset. And it was like, or short staff. We short staff. What I did, as you know, MC slash, you know, everything, I actually went outside, took some plate up, and I started to serve. Yes, I did start to serve. I think I served about 6 or 7 plates, because I realized that they didn't have so much waiter. I even go on the mic and say, if anybody else here want to volunteer to help serve, and then about 3 or 4 ladies get up and they go serve. It was one of the first weddings that I ever attend and see so much Caucasian persons. I mean, they was deep. They was in the bridal party. They was in the bridal party, and wadi yadi yadi, they was in the audience. And I even make 55 pound in the audience. Yeah, man, that was very nice. I made my tip and everything. So this is my first review on a wedding, actually. And it was good wedding. The crowd turnout for this lady, she have some heavy people in our company, meaning Caucasian, meaning the people them come out for this lady wedding. I become the family MC. This is going to be my third wedding for this family. So I want you to like and share this video, drop your comments. I really, really want to hear your comments and what I just, you know, talk about. You know, and if you are a catering company, please do the writing. The food, again, was a small amount. I mean, you know, people pay the catering company to cook food and everything. And when you look, when I saw what the bride and the groom get for their food, I was like, oh, snap. Me know me I got dead for hunger, right? Me know me now I get none. Because the food was so little bit. So I'm saying to you, catering company, I am a wedding MC. Once I go there, I look around and I see it. The person who do the decoration, trust me, I give you a 10. Yeah, I get a 10 right now for the decoration. So the decor was amazing. Drop your thoughts and comment in the comment section. Like this video. Like it.